Golriz from the UK asked, why do the Shia have great respect to Al-Khumayni? First of all, Golriz, Shia are different shades. Some of them are like us, with a small negligible difference, and they're very minute. So they only prefer Ali over Uthman, but they respect Abu Bakr and Umar, and they hold great position for them. They believe in what we believe in terms of Aqidah, blah, blah, blah. And the vast majority of Shia, especially those found in modern-day Persia or Iran, they are followers of the Imamiyah cult or Al-Ithna Ashariyah. And these guys' principles, their the religious origin, the origin of their religion, whether you can obtain it from Al-Kafi, from their books, from Al-Marja'iyat, as they call them, these are, in essence, in fundamentals, disbelievers. They believe in the distortion of the Quran, and it's found in their Al-Kafi book, which is equivalent to Al-Bukhari, our Bukhari. We Sunnis, when we see Al-Bukhari, we refrain. We say, this is the most authentic book. We accept what's in it. For them, Al-Kafi is Al-Bukhari, and they accept whatever is in it, and in it clearly mentioned that Al-Quran, the one we read, is distorted, is totally altered, and it's not relating to Mus'haf Fatima. This is blasphemous by itself. The concept of killing Abu Bakr and Umar, bringing them back to life with 3,000 or 4,000 from Quraysh, bringing them back to life, the Mahdi would do that, and then crucify them and kill them again, and accusing them of being kuffar, accusing Abu Bakr and Umar and slandering them to be al-jibt wa al-taghut, the cow that Allah mentioned to slaughter in Surah Al-Baqarah, in Moses' people. They say, it is Aisha, we have to slaughter her. She's an adulteress. A'udhu billah. This is all blasphemous. And this is what prevails there. And they don't have the cojitos to come and say, oh, this is wrong. It was done by those before us, but it's all baseless and we don't believe in it. No, they acknowledge it. So this is kufr by itself. Now, we don't care what they respect or not, because they don't belong, such apostates. They are enemies of Islam. They want to undermine the true Islam and tarnish its reputation. They're agents of KGB, it doesn't exist, but all the intelligence powers backed by them, backed by lobbies from the Jews. They never had any beef with the Jews. They're allies. So the issue is, we don't care what they respect. But when it comes to La'natullah al-Khumayni, the mentioned, who caused all this chaos in Iran, killed all or most of the Sunnis, oppressed them, had this war with Iraq, draining all the resources of the adjacent countries in such a fruitless war. Not only that, corrupted the Aqidah. In his book, Al-Dawla al-Islamiyya, the Muslim Nation, I think it's called or something, he clearly states that his 12 imams, whom the Imamiyah worship, beginning from Ali, Hassan al-Hussein, Hussein Abu Abdullah is Allahu Akbar, up to the Mahdi, who is a fictional character, does not exist, was not born. They made him up and gave him to the 11th Imam, who had no children, who was barren. And they say that for the past 1300 years, he's in a tunnel drinking from milk and honey. And they could only three or four in the state communicate with him and write things to him. So this Khomeini, La'natullah al-Khomeini, among the Ayatollahs, He comes and says that these 12 imams of ours are in a level lower than the messengers of Allah, but they are higher than the prophets of Allah. What more blasphemy do you want to hear? And if you go into these teachings, well, if you go to Wilayat al-Faqih, al-Ma'soom, where he considers himself to be infallible, and whatever he says must be executed and obeyed as if it's from Allah because he's a representative of Allah. This kind of doctrine is what drove the Muslim world into destruction. So they respect him because he valued their Persian history. And he made that a fork of the road. It's more important than Islam. It's more important than our belief in the Quran. And this is why we have An-Najaf, and we have Karbala, and we have Qum, and we have all of these sacred places of theirs, where they have a Kaaba, telling the people that visiting that Kaaba is much more rewardable than visiting the Kaaba of the Muslims. So, Akhi, your question has no sense to it when it comes to us Muslims, because we totally believe that these guys do not belong to Islam. I'm talking about the Imamiyya, the hardcore, who say that the Quran is altered and changed. If any one of them come and objects to that, no problem. Just tell me that you will scratch off and disregard all of the texts found in Al-Kafi or what Al-Tabrasi has written, Fasl al-Khitabi fi tahrifi, Kitabi Rabbi al-Arbab, etc. All of these books are there. It's in their libraries and they honor it and they study it. Once they manage to do this, then we will ask or talk about it.